Good morning. Welcome to the forecast discussion for January 2nd, 2014. It's currently 8:30 a.m. And of course, the focus for today's video will be on the upcoming winter storm that will be on the way for tonight on through tomorrow morning, with the potential for blizzard conditions from southern Connecticut through Long Island, New York City Metro, and into central New Jersey, and moderate to heavy snow throughout the entire northern mid-Atlantic. Currently, we have temperatures ranging from the mid to upper teens over the northern interior, lower to mid-20s over just to the north and west of New York City, upper 20s to lower 30s over the New York City Metro, and mid-30s for the most part over the Philadelphia Metro and New Jersey coast. Very interesting dynamics setting up for this afternoon. Temperatures over the northern interior and over the New York City Metro are not going to be moving all that much. Look for lower to mid-20s over the interior, upper 20s to lower 30s over the New York City Metro. In the Philadelphia Metro, look for mid-30s. Temperatures pretty much stagnant throughout the day. Along the New Jersey coast, though, because the Arctic cold front is still kind of hanging around here, temperatures are expected to warm into the mid to upper 30s. Now, there's some guidance that suggests the temperatures will push into the mid-40s, especially around Cape May. That's still a possibility, but I'm noticing that winds are coming in from the north all the way down through the Delmarva Peninsula when they were really supposed to be from the southeast at this point. So we might not warm up as much as what was expected over southern New Jersey, leading to a colder dynamic overall. Let me be very clear here. This Arctic air that's sitting up here over central New York and over portions of northern Pennsylvania is coming our way. That's why this storm is so interesting, because you have this dynamic low pressure system developing while Arctic air is clearly advancing. So the entire environment's becoming colder along the coastal plain where you and I live, while the water temperatures and the air mass over the Atlantic remains warm. This creates a very tight thermal gradient, which is basically like gasoline on fire, okay? It just causes a massive explosion of rapidly rising air as the atmosphere tries to balance out this dynamic. So that's pretty much why this whole system is very interesting and one that's very difficult to forecast for, aside from the fact we also have three phasing disturbances here to work with. And I'll show you those disturbances as well right now. On the radar, via IntelliCast, you can see we have that nice little hole that we were expecting with the precipitation shield, as we have the subtropical disturbance and the polar disturbance. Arctic disturbances up here around Ontario. Now, these two disturbances are already starting to interact and starting to show signs of phasing, and this hole will basically start to collapse as we go on through the day. We're already starting to see that over the New York City Metro with a few scattered snow showers over Connecticut. This will increase throughout the day as temperatures continue to hold and then start to fall this evening through the 30s, 20s, and eventually the teens. So everything's pretty much setting up via the radar as what was expected. This hole in the precipitation shield will start to fill in. We're already starting to see that very nicely here, carving itself out. So we'll be dry throughout the morning with a few scattered snow showers and flurries. Over the northern tier, you're already going to start off with your accumulation as that light snow starts to develop. Excuse me. Now, here we have the water vapor satellite picture. I'm going to show you a couple different looks at the 500 millibar pattern here. First, as we see it right now on the water vapor satellite picture, here's our subtropical jet stream. Here's our polar disturbance tapping into that subtropical jet stream. And way up here, here's our Arctic disturbance that forces this trough to go negative. As you can see, we have plenty of moisture to work with here, plenty of cold air. We have our blocking high pressure system over Quebec. We have our polar vortex that has shifted towards the Canadian Maritimes, slowing this whole storm down. That's why, by the way, the GFS from last night was holding that back, that precipitation, to linger on a little bit longer because of that factor with a negatively tilted trough and an inverted trough at the surface. Let's take a little bit better look, though, at this. This is basically the 500 millibar atmosphere right now via SPC. And what I want to point out is that our trough has gone neutral over the Mississippi River Valley. This is a huge, huge indication here. When you want to see a winter storm rapidly develop, you need a trough to go neutral at this point right now. The reason why is because of dynamics. You see, if the trough goes neutral at this point, That gives it enough time to go negative by the time it reaches the eastern United States or the East Coast. Now, a negative trough is like this, okay, oriented from basically southeast to northwest. And that's an important feature because it does three things. One, it leads to rapid rising of air over the coastal waters. Two, slows down the storm just enough to allow for a moderate to heavy snowfall to linger over the coastal plain. And three, supports the potential for what's called an inverted trough, which I'll show on the model guide, which is basically a lingering area low pressure along the coastal plain, along the thermal gradient that's going to set up for this evening. Here is our Arctic disturbance well to the north, just outside the picture. The base of the trough is starting to show up right here. Notice there's a clear separation between subtropical jet stream, polar jet stream. Those two are starting to phase. And then you have your Arctic jet stream with the trough over here. That is what's going to force this trough to go negative later on this evening. And that is what basically is what drives the storm to be able to produce moderate to heavy snow from eastern Pennsylvania through New England. Without this trough going negative, it's too progressive of a storm, and the heaviest snowfall would just be focused over New England rather than the New York City metropolitan area and Philadelphia metropolitan area. Here is the infrared satellite picture. I want to point this out because of what we see here in the observations. Notice that these clouds are cooling rapidly. Let me explain why this is important. The more clouds cool, it means that they're higher in the atmosphere. So if they're higher in the atmosphere, that means there's more lifting. So if you have intense lifting already starting to focus along the coast, that is a clear indication that we're starting to set up that intense thermal gradient. All the focus of the best dynamics are shifting towards the coast, and that is a clear indication of a major winter storm on the way. This up here is not cloud cover, that's cold air. It is so cold that it's showing up on the infrared satellite picture. Very impressive. So these low pressure systems, we got another one down here in the Gulf of Mexico, they're all basically going to phase into one low pressure system southeast of New Jersey that's going to track just to the south of the benchmark. And that's what's going to produce our very intense snowfall. This is the latest wrap, guys. I want to show you basically what to expect with this storm moving forward. And the key point here is that, you know, you see snow showers through the day into the afternoon. This evening, we'll start to see steady snow developing. Tonight, this is where it gets intense. See these yellow shades? That's 35 to 40 dBZ. That's basically a radar echo. When you get rain, 35 to 40 dBZ is, you know, heavy, but not crazy. When you're talking about snow, though, that's intense. Because remember, snow is harder to pick up on the radar. So if you're seeing this type of precipitation focusing over New Jersey, and notice it's basically focusing from the Delaware River on east this evening, that is some very heavy snowfall as the comet head starts to develop and very heavy snowfall sets up. But an interesting dynamic here, as this is occurring, is that our temperatures at all levels of the atmosphere are also starting to cool or get cold very rapidly. So here's that brief warm-up this afternoon over southern New Jersey. Notice, basically from Philadelphia on north, temperatures really don't move all that much. And then, tonight, those temperatures start to crash. And look at this tight thermal gradient. We go from the teens to the 40s off the coast. That's roughly a 30-degree thermal gradient, and that is intense. That's going to lead to intensification of the precipitation band over much of the coastal plain as a result. And also at 850 millibars, it's cold enough for snow for the entire event at the mid levels of the atmosphere. But this point right here is an important point. Notice the tight thermal gradient that sets up, but also notice, this is important, that the 850 millibar low starts to shift towards the coast, and notice the wind set up here. As the 850 millibar low starts to set up and intensify to the southwest, southeast of New Jersey, after about, let's say about 2 a.m., you're going to see an intense band of snow basically set up from southern Connecticut back through New York City, Long Island, and along the coast of New Jersey as this mid-level low pressure system intensifies over this thermal gradient right here. And that is what's going to lead to the potential for blizzard conditions, especially as these winds intensify at the mid-levels. And I want to show you something that's a little bit. You probably won't see all that often from other meteorologists here, but I want to show you this. These are, let me see if I can get the winds here. I want to kind of make this point. It's kind of important. I should have had this loaded. I apologize. Perfect. Here we go. Okay. These are the winds at this time period at basically 1 a.m. And these winds are pretty strong. You're talking about 30, 40, 50 knots just off the ground. And the reason why I'm bringing this up is that these strong winds are likely going to get mixed down through southern New England, Connecticut, Long Island, New York City, and much of the northern half of New Jersey. And that's why there's a potential for what's called blizzard conditions tonight, basically from Monmouth and Ocean counties of New Jersey through northeastern New Jersey, through Long Island, New York City, and southern Connecticut, really much Connecticut, because of these strong winds reducing visibility to near zero at times. Remember, this is a very fine, dry snow, so it's going to be blown in the atmosphere quite a bit. So late tonight, especially after 7 p.m., these conditions are going to get rough, they're going to get nasty, and visibility is going to crash early tomorrow morning as well. It's just going to be nasty out there. Okay, so here's the basic forecast that we have set up. Again, start time, that basically means scattered snow showers, has started already. We've seen scattered snow showers around the region. Steady snow between 5 p.m. this afternoon through 8 a.m. tomorrow morning, ending from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. from west to east. Snowfall amounts, looking at 8 to 16 inches over the northern interior. Again, we're going to have to watch out for banding and also the influence of high snow ratios in these areas. That's what's going to get you to very impressive snowfall totals in these areas. Dark bluish shade, basically covering Long Island, New York City Metro, central New Jersey, and portions of northeastern Pennsylvania. Looking at 6 to 12 inches. That plus is due to intense banding. The best potential for banding is basically in this area right here, okay? This area right here will feature the coldest thermal gradient, the best upper level support, and it'll be close enough to the low pressure system to really get into that comma head as it starts to develop. So watch out for this area for intense mesoscale banding, thus enhancing your snowfall totals. As you move a little bit further south towards the Philadelphia Metro, looking at 4 to 8 inches of snow, to the south of the Philadelphia Metro and towards south central or southwestern New Jersey, looking anywhere from 3 to 6 inches of snow. And then the pink shades over southern New Jersey, because we're going to be mixing a little bit more rain and snow, looking anywhere from 1 to 4 inches of snow. The longer the changeover takes, the less snow you'll see. Again, in the purple and dark blue areas have the highest threat for mesoscale banding, thus the potential for snowfall totals becoming enhanced and more impressive than what some model guidance suggests. Something to keep an eye on as always. And of course, expect blizzard conditions over Connecticut, much of southeastern New York, and north and central New Jersey. That is the forecast for the most part, okay? We're going to be covering this storm throughout the day, watching it evolve. If there are any changes to the forecast, of course, you'll hear about it first. And all you got to do is follow nynjpaweather.com and nynjpaweather on Twitter, Facebook, Google+, and LinkedIn. And of course, I'm your meteorologist, Stephen DiMartino. Thank you for following, and as always, stay safe out there.